This week, not quite dudes, sub-dudes.
Faith and Vigora, it's Mary Margaret O'Hara.
Tom talks to large stars.
And we promise not to ask for money.
Stay where you are. We'll send someone up to help you. Next on Videospin. Subway. Hi, and welcome to Videospin, where we're this close. I'm Scott Paulson.
And I'm Tom Downing. And actually we're this close. You see, there's this this marketing guy who is trying to sell the show to underwriters, national underwriters. He keeps coming in every week. And like last week, or like 2 weeks ago, we were that close. Now, last week, we're this close. Now, this week, we're that close. So we are this close to getting
underwriters.
Next week. That close. Dave Thomas and the band Pere Ubu have been successful over the years in creating yet another new music term, that of avant-garage, high-tech thought with solid rock approach. In the early days, they worked around Cleveland, Ohio, where they confused most everyone but themselves. Over the next decade, they changed their lineup no less than 13 times, but managed to gain critical and major label support along the way. Their most recent effort, Cloudland, shows Pere Ubu continuing their efforts to both please and confuse. Here's Breathe.
Almost down the sidewalk. Had I not given up?
That's Dave Thomas and Pere Ubu. A real pop song for them.
Yeah.
Something they haven't done much in the past.
Apparently the bills. The bills yeah. start filing up and they say, oh, look, we better pay that one. No, you said that somebody came up to them and said what?
Yeah, they said, well, why don't you guys sort of like do a more pop album? And they were like, oh, there's a good idea.
So now maybe they'll make some bucks. And speaking of making bucks, a good way to do that is to invent something. And that's the subject of this week's pop quiz, inventions. Thing we need to tell you about our next work is the fact that it took close to 12 years to make its way to your small screen. Miss America, the 12-year work of Mary Margaret O'Hara, is an interesting blend of styles that reflect the fact that young Mary took a dozen years to write it. After all, a person changes over 12 years. I mean, what were you doing in 1977, huh? Here's Mary Margaret O'Hara with Bodies in Trouble.
What are you talking about?
May be wrong because I don't have official credits for this album, but looking at that video, that I think is Dave Alvin playing guitar.
Really?
From the Blasters. It looked like Dave Alvin. I might be wrong. Mary Margaret O'Hara.
Yeah. The video was done by Matt Mahorin, who did like a lot of Tracy Chapman stuff.
Right.
But I was just really drawn to this song the first time I heard it. It's kind of, she's got that lilting, kind of haunting voice. I really like this a lot.
But Matt, the video. Buy some color film. I'm tired of this black and white stuff.
Me too. As the holidays approach, the new releases are coming out fast and furious. In 4 and 60, we endeavor to steer you through the recent crunch so that you can find the best of what's out there. First, Warren Zevon checks in from Transverse City. He takes a poke at life in the late 80s with a jab at every concern from shopping malls to the ozone layer. Each track comes off as a dark scenario of the future, leaving us bummed out and without answers. The songs are well crafted and the backup talent's first rate, but there's rarely any variation in style or sound. Next, Will and the Bushmen come our way on the newly formed SBK Records. Unfortunately, they suffer from sounds like disease. Yes, they can play, yes, they can write, and yes, they sound like Let's Active and the Connells. If SBK is to carve out a niche in the alternative scene, they'll need a sharper band than this. The Vulgar Boatmen are this week's pick with their release, You and Your Sister. Simplicity rules here. The Boatmen turn in an understated but powerful performance. No wall of sound here, just a guitar, bass, and drums filling the void. That's all that's needed to produce a solid collection of country-tinged alternative pop. And finally, it's Live from the Knitting Factory, Volume 2. The Knitting Factory is a performance space and experimental music club in New York City. This release tries to capture live the avant-garde angst that goes down in the club. And for the most part, it works, but one gets the feeling that being there is at least half the fun. So does the other half hold up? Depends on your patience and imagination. Recapping, Warren Zevon's Transverse City, depressing, repetitious, and a C. Will and the Bushmen, not bad, but you've heard it before, also a C. The Vulgar Boatmen grabbed top honors this week, a B+, and the Knitting Factory is unique and interesting, but at times tedious, a B-.
That's kind of a disappointment, the Warren Zevon not being that good. Not apparently being as funny.
No, none of the tongue-in-cheek stuff that you saw in the earlier releases.
That was always one of the best things about him. I mean, he was a good musician and wrote marvelous, love songs, beautiful, Accidentally Like a Martyr is a just beautiful song, but the funny stuff was always stuff that pulled me through.
Yeah, me too. It's a real disappointment that that he didn't come through on this release. Oh, well. It's real easy to get jaded about the music industry. I mean, you figure that the chances of anyone making it in the business are basically slim and none, and unless you're the next new kids on the block, no one wants to have anything to do with you. Then something like this happens. An unknown music teacher gives a demo tape to a friend. That friend happens to know that ex-Police drummer Stuart Copeland is looking for a lead vocalist to round out a band featuring bass player Stanley Clark. Stuart hears the tape, hires the school teacher, they cut an album, and the next thing you know, they're on a national video show, and another rock and roll dream has come true. Here's the outcome from the band Animal Logic.
There's a spy in the house of love, and he knows what I'm thinking of. He's making friends in places high above. In the house of love, in the house of love. I had dreams, they were laid to waste. I lost the time, and I lost the taste. I need him now to meet me face to face. In the house of love, in the house of love. Someday I'll know who it is, and what I do. It's hard to rise above the sense of doom. In the house of love, in the house of love. Someday I'll find out who he is, and when I do, he'll probably go. Some message can only be his, whatever it says.
Now, you know who Stuart Copeland's father is, don't you?
Miles.
Yeah, Miles Copeland.
Miles.
He owns IRS Records, who Animal Logic records on. So I'm thinking that Stuart could come in there with, like, Lyle Alzado and Connie Chung,
right,
and he'd let them record. And let's do an album, you know?
Ah, yeah. The Alzado Chung Band. Yeah, I really didn't like this video a whole lot, because
really?
What they're playing on stage is not what you're hearing, so.
Yeah. Oh, I like the sound, though. I like the sound.
Blah, blah, blah. Let's check now what's popular across the country on radio with Cross Country Tracks.
In the past, you've heard me rave on about the Pixies, who I consider to be one of the most exciting bands of 1989. Well, right now, they're on the highways and byways, rocking up the country and spreading their angry gospel. When they hit our particular burg, I was there in a flash to talk with lead singers Black Francis and Kim Deal.
The Pixies will never play, never play in West Palm Beach, ever, ever.
The songwriting process. I write a basic song, without any words, like a chord progression in my bathroom. And then I go off to Dave's garage and meet up with her and the other two. And we turn everything on and we just jam on it until it sounds good.
If we were sitting around playing on a song and we would like look at each other and say, doesn't this sound a lot like la 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 la? And then we, oh yeah, it does. Or, you know, and then we wouldn't want to do that.
Usually never gets that far. No. Sometimes, like, if you, like, start stealing from yourself, then you, like, know, and you go, oh, I can't
and, or
do
like,
that.
Or, like, oh, we already did that. And David would say, oh, these are the exact same drums to blah, 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 blah. And it's like, oh, who cares?
I hate that alternative crap stuff. It's like, I like it that there's college radio and all that stuff, and there's alternative bands, and there's a circuit that everyone go to, but there's this thing that just because they're alternative, that they're good. There's just as many crap alternative bands as there are, like, crap top 40 bands. And I suppose lots of people know that, but I don't know. I think not enough people say it. Look at me. I mean, look at me. You know, I'm going to put on a pair of sunglasses, and I'm going to be like a rock star. I mean, look at the way I look. You know what I mean? It's just like, screw
no
it.
Chance.
You know what I mean?
There's
it's
no
like,
we can do that.
I play in a band. It's like, I don't give a shit about everything, all that other stuff. I mean, I don't know. I mean, I wish I could get up there and act like Mick Jagger, but it would look stupid. And besides, you know, it's like, rock and roll is like so old, and everything's been done, and you know what I mean?
Band with no plan.
That's our credo. That's our saying. We just came up with it. Some guy said, you're like a band with no plan. And I said, hey, we're like a band with no plan. We are like a band with no plan. We have no message.
No message.
Except that you better not have ripped off your copy of the record. You better not try to sneak into our gigs. You better pay the ticket price.
And no t-shirts from bootleggers. Okay?
So what's the deal with the orange cones?
In the background?
Yeah.
Well, we're sort of shooting the whole thing in a banquet room, and we didn't have anything to make it look nice, so that was my idea for set design. Did you think it was kind of eclectic?
Francis Ford Coppola. Francis Ford Downing
Isn't it nice?
Strikes again.
Yeah.
When we told you at the top of the show we'd be playing a selection from the Subdudes, what came to mind? A bunch of boombox-wielding, skateboard-riding, youths gone wild Subdudes! No, not Subdudes, but Subdued. Like subdued, laid back. The band itself used to be a wild rock and rhythm bunch out of New Orleans called the Continental Drifters, and all along they've been writing this material. It was a little too laid back for the band's format, so the solution they created, a brand new band, a character band to play the tunes. Thus, we now have the Subdudes. After a couple of years of gigging constantly in clubs across America, the Subdudes ventured in the studio earlier this year, and this is one of the results. Thinking that it might feel better.
touch is what I miss. Must I ask you, please, miss, to hold me, touch my love. Is there any cure for being alone?
There's the Subdudes. We're kind of a throwback to the,
You know what? You look like Betty.
Betty?
Yeah, on
Betty
the Archies.
Veronica with the tambourine.
Yeah, very nice. What is that?
This is my official Subdudes tambourine. You see, the Subdudes don't use drums in their band. All they use is the tambourine.
Hope you kids at home are listening. Just say no to
just
drums.
Just say no to drums. And as a matter of fact, if you call now with a completed pledge of just $5 a month, you too can get...
No more of that. We're done with that. No more asking for money for a while.
Well, for a completed pledge of just $7...
No, Tom. No more asking for money. We promised at the top of the show.
Okay. Well, I'll give you the tambourine anyway, and also this week's pop quiz answer.
Jukebox, San Francisco, 1899.
Right.
Song most played on that jukebox?
Shout.
That's good. That's good. You light up my life, Debbie Boone.
Okay. I was going to say Truckin' next.
Yeah, we're going to Great Bodega, San Francisco. Next week, we have something brand new from Joe Strummer for
and,
you.
And Loudon Wainwright, plus David Byrne. It's a huge show. Giant.
We're this far